I'm really loving my current apartment.
Let's make this love last till Valentine's. Let's spend this night together. Let this fire burn inside our hearts. Let us soak in all the pleasure.
Hi everyone, it's Sheren. Today is Saturday and I don't have any plans outside, so I finally gathered my will and my motivation to record an apartment tour video. Finally. Some of you may have known me from my Hong Kong life, so you guys probably already have like some ideas about what it's like renting an apartment in Hong Kong. But for those of you who are just with me since my Seoul journey, here's a disclaimer. So I came from Hong Kong. I have lived in 3 tiny apartments for the past 5 years or so. That's why I kind of have a high expectation when finding apartments in Seoul. Also, since I'm from Hong Kong, I've experienced the ups and downs of living in a tiny space. So let's just say that I have completely different lens or mindset. In other words, we might have different opinions about apartments in Seoul, which is fine, by the way. But just bear in mind that this is all based on my POV. So yeah, anyway, I can't believe that I finally got to say this, but I'm really loving my current apartment. This place ticks off almost everything in my priority list. You may think,
really? There's no way you can find a place like that without any cons.
Of course, there are things that make me feel bummed or annoyed. So yes, as I always said, finding the perfect apartment is like finding the right boyfriend or girlfriend. It seems impossible, but the chance is never zero. If you really look hard enough and you can tolerate a few things, you might find the one. A very nice apartment, I mean. So the monthly rent is 630,000 won. People might say that it's too expensive, but again, I used to pay double the price for a place that is way smaller than this. After all, I've worked for 5 years and saved the money, and now I got to spend it for a better life. So there are only 2 things that really annoy me from this place. One, the fact that the deposit amount is really high. The monthly rent is 630,000. The deposit, which I will get back when the contract ends, is 10 million. The maintenance fee is 100,000, and electricity bills depends on my usage. It's just crazy. But this is how renting an apartment is in Korea. The other thing that I was really bummed about is this apartment came semi-furnished, but without the 2 most important things, bed and curtains. Setting the bed was not really like a problem. I just hate that I need to spend money on it. I'll show you guys the bed later. But buying and setting up your curtains, my god, it's one of the hardest things. It was crazy. I was curtainless for like a month or so. It was like terrifying. I have no idea what type of curtains that can fit in this type of window. Like I just have no idea. And then I need to look it up online, and after so many back and forth because I have to translate everything, I finally found one type of curtain. I'm so surprised that curtains are so expensive. Like, why? So do you think that's the end of my suffering? Of course no, because I had to install the curtains by myself. So installing this curtains is my worst nightmare. I had to deal with this window screw or something. It's so difficult when you have to do it in real life. And then when I tried to place this curtain rod, I realized that it couldn't fit like how it's supposed to. In the end, I successfully installed my curtains, although one part was not really clicked. I was just hoping that it will never fall down on my face. So I asked my Korean friend. He said that usually people will buy the curtains and then ask the staff to come and install it for them. And I was like, what? So I have to let someone into my room and then deal with the language barrier? Yeah, no, thank you. Anyways, this shows that I'm actually capable of doing things that I thought I couldn't. First time installing curtains on a big window at the age of 27, like, what? Anyways, enough for my TED talk about the curtains. I'm really sorry, I just really wanted to let this out because it's an annoying situation, but it's also a proud moment for me. So yeah, for now, I'm gonna show you around. So yeah, please stay tuned. So we start here. This is the entrance of the room. When you first get in, there's this shoe cabinet on your left. I don't really have that many shoes, but it's pretty spacious. Then on the right here, this is a full body length mirror, which is kind of useful, so every time I'm about to go out, I can just check myself first. This is the kitchen area. It's just next to the shoe cabinet, so it's near the bathroom. Even though it's literally side by side, it's kind of still separated. Also, I'm not someone who really likes to cook, so I think this small but decent kitchen is already enough for me. Actually, more than enough, because, you know, in Hong Kong, I couldn't really get a lot of storage space. And I just like the design, all white, and it's very neat. Everything is built in, so I don't really have to install anything. Like, this washing machine was already there. And also this induction cooker. The only thing that I need to buy is the microwave. So yeah, this kitchen is just enough for me. This part here is where I store my tea collection and instant noodle from Indonesia. It's still messy, so I don't really like it. You can't really see from this frame, but the fridge is exactly next to the kitchen set. The fridge is also built in, so I don't really have to buy and install it by myself. And honestly, because I don't really cook, I thought I wouldn't really need such a big fridge. So this is the bathroom area. I gotta say, when I first looked at it, immediately I was like, okay, this is the one, because I want to have a bathroom that is separated and it's very decent as well. This one is a bit funny because they kind of separate it into two rooms, while usually it's one bathroom with a shower room inside. But still, it's perfect because I feel like bathroom is really important. So yeah, this is actually like the plus point from this apartment, really. Okay, so this is my desk area. This is one of my favorite spots. Obviously, apart from my bed, I haven't really decorated it, but it's pretty organized. I've got my album collection. I don't know, maybe I should bring you guys closer. So I really like this Korean band called Day6, and my collection's not that many actually, but I'm getting there. This is my latest purchase, and I don't even have a tape player, but it's just pretty. Right here, it's pretty much my skincare and makeup stuff. Up there, it's books and stationery, and that one right there, it's pretty much everything that I need to keep. Okay, so this is the bed area. I don't have any particular reason, but I kind of set the bed near the window. I'm pretty proud of myself for setting this bed alone. I don't really have the bed frame because, again, I don't want to invest too much on the furniture. I really like this bed because it's near the window, but I was thinking maybe I want to have a change in terms of the layout. Also, I want to show you guys something. This is the truth behind the camera, okay? You guys need to see. This is the pile of clothes that I need to wash and sort out.
Right here, there's a door.
Inside, there's an aircon and a heater, and there's a window that I need to close or open depending on the season. I was thinking maybe I should move this pile of clothes because otherwise then I will wake up and sleep to this view, which is pretty sad because it reminds me that I have to do my laundry. I might move this bed to somewhere. I'm not too sure, honestly. I need to work on the layout, but it requires a lot of energy and effort, so I might just procrastinate and do nothing. If you guys have any like suggestions, please feel free to let me know because I'm pretty confused. Kind of like it that the bed is here because it's like very efficient in terms of the usage of the space. But I feel like I need a workspace with a great lighting, so... But anyways, let's move on to the last part of this room. So basically, there's the bed here, and this is just a free space. This is a pile of clothes that I just moved. I did plan to have like a small tea table, but... I don't know, I was thinking that it might be too stuffy for this room. In the end, I didn't get it. But I already ordered this, so now it came and there's no purpose. Behind me, there's a mirror as well. This is actually my dilemma because for this area, I really need a good lighting for doing my makeup. So that's why I was thinking of moving the bed to this area and this whole thing will be near the window. There's nothing much here because I don't have anything to decorate or make this space prettier. Alright, so that's it for today's apartment tour. I hope you guys enjoy watching this video. And if some of you are looking to find an apartment in Seoul, you can also refer to my apartment hunting video because I basically explain the process more on that video rather than here. Thank you so much guys for watching. I will see you in my next video soon. Bye!